Welcome to another video in which we are going to write Python program to return multiple values from a function. So guys, there are two ways to return multiple values from a function. We have already seen how we can return one value from a function by using the return keyword, but how do we return multiple values? So the first way is by returning values using comma, and then the second way is by using a dictionary. We will check the examples using both these ways using the VS Code over here. So let us see the examples now. So let us say we have a function over here. We use the DEF keyword in order to define the function, and let's say the function name is language in this case. Now guys, since this is a function, we have to provide open and close parentheses over here. We are not providing any parameters, so we have colon, and then what we will be doing is, let's say we have two strings over here to be returned. So we have str1 as the first string, and we will say Python in this case as the language, and the second string, that is str2, we will simply say language over here. Now guys, we want to return both these strings from this particular function, that is language. So what we can do is, simply we have to use the return keyword followed by space, and then in order to return just one value, we can simply provide the variable name, that is str1 over here. So in this case, only Python will be returned. But what if we want to return this language as well? So we will provide comma, and then we will provide str2 as well. Over here, both these strings will be returned as a tuple. So from wherever we are calling this method, that is language, it will get two values, that is string 1 and string 2 being returned. So let us check that. Over here, what we will be doing is, we will simply have the print statement, and we will call this language function over here. So let me just copy this and paste this over here inside the print statement followed by open and close parentheses. So basically, we should get the tuple having Python and language as the values. Let me just save this file now and try running this code. So as you can see, we have got the tuple. It is being enclosed within the open and close parentheses, and then we have two values, that is Python and language over here. Guys, can we return more than two values? Yes, it can be done. So what we can do is, let's say we have another string over here, str3, and then we say is good in this case. So we are saying Python language is good using these three strings over here, and in the return statement we will say string 3 in this case. So when we call this method, that is language, all the three strings will be returned and it will be printed. So let me just save this file now and try running this code. So as you can see, we have Python language and then is good being returned from the function as a tuple over here. Now guys, this tuple can also be iterated by using the for loop. So how we can print them? Just by separating using the space characters. So what we will do is, we will assign this returned tuple to a variable. So over here, we will say tuple in this case. So we say tuple1 as the variable name on the left hand side. And then guys, we will be using the for loop I in tuple. So we can use this tuple1 as the variable name, and then we can simply use this I variable to print the content of this tuple. So we say I, and then we also have to use the end parameter so that all the elements are separated with the space character over here. So for the end parameter, we have provided the space character. Let me just save this file now and try running this code once again. So as you can see, we have got Python language is good. So these three strings are being returned as a tuple, and then using this tuple, we are using the for loop in order to print all of the individual strings that are being returned, and all of them are being separated by using the space character over here. We can use any other character. So let's say if we use hyphen, so instead of space characters, we will be getting the hyphen characters. Let me just save this file now and try running this code. As you can see, we have got hyphen over here in between all the strings. So guys, this is one of the ways in order to return multiple values from a function. Let us see another way, that is by using a dictionary. So guys, what we can do is, instead of returning these individual strings using the variable names, we can form a dictionary over here. So we will have to modify this return statement over here. Instead of providing this strings, we have to provide open and close curly braces, and as you must be knowing, in a dictionary we have the key value pairs. So over here, let's say we provide the key, that is 1, and then on right hand side we have to provide the value after providing a colon over here. So let's say the value for 1, it is string 1, and then let's say we have another key, that is 2, and then for which the value it is string 2 over here, and then for the key 3, we have the value string 3 in this case. So So guys, basically this dictionary will help us in order to access the values based on these keys that we already know, that is 1, 2 and 3. So we simply have to call this function, that is language, and print the content of the dictionary. So we will have the print statement and simply we will call this language function over here. So this time we will get the dictionary instead of a tuple in this case. So let me just save this file now and try running this code. So as you can see, we have got the dictionary, we have got all the key value pairs, that is 1 for Python and then 2 for language and then 3 for is code over here. And then similarly, we can also use the for loop in order to iterate through all of the key value pairs one at a time. So guys, I'll leave that exercise as a homework for you so that you can practice on your own. Guys, what will be the output if I change this string to best over here? So comment in the comment section below what will be the output in this case. Let us see whether your answer is correct or not. Please make sure that you like this video so that it reaches to more people, and subscribe to the channel so that you get the notifications on upcoming videos as well. The next video that we are going to talk about is Python program to get line count of a file. So stay tuned.